before World War II, society had very little interest and concern with research and researchers. They were more or less left by themselves to determine how they conduct research. After what came out in the Nuremberg trials, where the atrocities, the brutality that happened in Nazi concentration camps, society became more concerned about research and ethics. From that point onwards, researchers had to be clear on how they conduct their research. However, it was still up to the researcher to decide the extent to which they engage with being accountable. It was only in 1964 that there has been more or less a worldwide attempt to establish an international model according to which researchers had to conduct themselves ethically. Declaration of Helsinki, 1964. This declaration has subsequently been revised, and currently there's a call for the public to contribute to towards this revision. The basic bottom line with this declaration is that scientific review needs to happen prior to a research project being embarked on. It is only after the Belmont report was released in 1979 that there was a realization of individuals or individual researchers not being able to stick to ethical requirements. Subsequently, governments had to intervene and design and draft regulation to guide research, responsible conduct of research. In 2010, a number of delegates from all over the world came together and formulated the Singapore Statement on Research Integrity. We are currently in a situation where globally there is an attempt to have more or less uniform regulation informed by governments' independent laws in this regard.